Hi there, it's Teresa, and I want to thank you for allowing me to take just one moment of your time. I want to share with you a recent experience that just reminded me about conversations that we have with people no matter what the age is. The other day I was visiting my 86-year-old mom, and we were able to do some social distancing within the community, which was wonderful. We were driving to a local park so we could go for a walk, and she was commenting during the drive in regards to changes and how things are moving so fast and how hard it is to keep up. She mentioned a comment. She says, "I just don't belong anymore." And it took me by surprise, and I said, "Well, sure you do." And so, you know, we got to the park and we were going for a walk and had a little bit of lunch. Nothing else was really mentioned in regards to what she had said in the car. I dropped her back off at home and said her goodbyes and off we went. I was thinking on my drive home about what she had said and that I really had missed a moment with her. You know, my response to her comments in my mind was, "Don't be silly, of course you belong." But what I did is I neglected to see things through her eyes. I neglected to really listen to what she was actually saying and giving her time to say more about how she was feeling. Sometimes a few changes in the selective words that we use really opens up the door to conversations. I wonder what might have happened if I had said to her, "Tell me more about that. You mentioned that you don't feel that you belong. Well, what does that mean?" You know, it also makes me really, really think about the conversations that we have with children and how often we forget to take that moment to step back, to pause, to really listen to what they are actually saying, because it really does open up the door to more conversations. I made a phone call the other night to my mom, and I just wanted to follow up with her and chat with her a little bit more about what she was saying in the car and how she was feeling about getting old. You know, what I know is that it's never too late to have conversations. The important thing is that conversations do happen. In my next few posts, what I'd like to do is dive a little bit deeper into connecting with children through conversations. You know, it's amazing how much they think and how much we actually really miss sometimes about what they're thinking and what they're feeling. Through the eyes of a child really reminds us of how beautiful our world really is. Down below also, I've included some links to some interesting information that I thought you might like to read. And, you know, I really do want to say thank you very much for allowing me to take another moment of your time. And you take care. Bye-bye.